Tim! We're supposed to be recording Tool Time! Tim! What is going on, guys? So today we're back with another video talking about the electric types inside of the Jungle Cup. So basically, these are the top 5 Pokemon from PvPoke. Except I tried to clump some of them together because they had very similar objectives and roles and things like that. But that made it extremely hard for the last two that we go over. So just keep in mind, once we get past these first three, I am sort of starting to grasp at straws trying to figure out a place to put these Pokemon. And there were a lot of other Pokemon that could have fit into the number 4 and number 5 slot, but technically, according to PvPoke, these two that I chose do outperform the other ones. So I did try to figure out why they were at least there. So anyways, let's get started with our Rock Boys. We do have both Golem and Graveler. Now, these are the Alolan forms, just to make sure. Only electric types, so we have to go with the Alolan Golem and Alolan Graveler. So according to PvPoke, up against the entire Jungle Cup, they do both have around a 50% win rate. Of course, that's against the entire cup, so that's pretty decent, and that's in the 1v1 shield scenario, so that's okay. But the biggest deal here is that it's a really good target for both the flying types in the cup, because we do have access to rock type fast moves, and we do have access to the electric type moves as well. So the big deal here is that we do have those rock type moves, though, which actually helps us go up against both flyers and the bug type, which is pretty gnarly. So it is a great option. If bug types end up being the bigger type here, then that makes it a really good target for the rock typing to just be able to throw rocks and, you know, smash the bugs. But you do have to kind of keep in mind both Vigoroth and Heracross can actually be a big deal if we do go with these two Pokemon, so kind of given a little bit of a problem there. And I will say that Golem does seem to inch out against Graveler just slightly, and it seems to be due to the fact that Golem actually has Wild Charge, whereas Alolan Graveler actually doesn't get it. But they are both extremely comparable, extremely similar. So let's take a quick look at our Golem here. We're actually going to go into PvPoke. You can see just a random moveset here: Rock Throw, Stone Edge, Wild Charge. It is the auto select. Oh, well, okay. It's not quite the auto select, but we're definitely going to give it Wild Charge rather than two rock type moves there. So as you can see, around a 50% win ratio here. And some notable wins, of course, are going to be the ones that are super weak to those rock type moves. Like Zapdos, we have most of the bugs here. Some of the flying types you can see show up there. Ampharos, oddly enough. Armaldo still, you know, going to be having an issue. Farfetch'd, more bugs, more flying. Then we start to get into the Slaking, which Slaking just in PvP is a joke, unfortunately. Snover, actually that ice type is going to have a problem there. You can kind of see that it's pretty much just the same old targets there for quite a while. But if we go down here and start to see what we're weak to, you can see that it really starts to show the grass types are going to be a huge issue for us. Anything that has access to any kind of fighting type move is going to be kind of a big deal, like Kangaskhan. I mean, it's really awkward, some of the matches that we lose here. Some of the hidden power users are going to show up here, like Porygon. You do see Munchlax actually shows up here. Cradilly and Lilleap are actually a big deal for us. Heracross is a big deal. So basically, if they have a way to get under the skin of that rock type, then it's a pretty much done deal. Our next set of Pokemon that we're going to go over are the Steel Boys, which are actually Magneton and Magnezone. Now, oddly enough, usually it ends up working out to a fully evolved Pokemon doesn't necessarily do as well as a non-fully evolved Pokemon. But in this case, based on what I can find, Magnezone actually does seem to outperform Magneton just slightly. So in PvPoke, we do have around a 61.9% win ratio with both of these. Again, these are going to be targeting the flyers, but we do lose the target up against the bugs. There are a few bugs that we can still do pretty well up against, like Scyther, Masquerain, Vespiquen, the ones that actually carry that flying typing, but that's the reason that we're doing good against those. It's not just all bugs. But one interesting thing that we do carry with these, just like we had rock type moves for the Rock Boys, we actually do have steel type moves for the Steel Boys, which actually does pretty interesting. There's not going to be too many Pokemon out there that actually end up resisting that steel type move, so it ends up having a pretty nice like general type coverage whenever we're using that, which actually does help quite a bit. And if you think that 61.9% compared back to the Rock Boys doing around 50%, the Steel Boys seem to be doing a little bit better there. Now let's take a look at our Magnezone here with Spark as our fast move. We're going to do Flash Cannon and Wild Charge there, and we're just going to hit battle. And as you can see, around a 61.9%, not too shabby. If we look at what we're actually going to be winning up against, you can see a ton of these are going to be the flying types. These are going to be our main target here, just as we would expect. But since we do have that steel type move, it actually does help us up against a couple of these rock types, like Cradillish actually showing up there at the top. You can see a couple of the more obscure bug types are going to start appearing here. Some of the ones that do carry that flying type associated with them as well. A notable win here though is Fortress actually showing up here, which is pretty nice. And then you can see we can just kind of beat down some of these middle of the road Pokemon. If we go down to what we're really going to start losing to though, Luxray actually shows up here, Breloom, Porygon, some hidden power users here at the bottom of course, but Breloom is a big one. Going to be exploiting that steel type weakness that we do have to fighting. Does that make sense? It's going to be exploiting the weakness that we have to fighting because we are a steel type. You can actually see Raikou actually has a pretty favorable matchup here. Heracross, of course, we expect. Pinsir, Meganium. Basically, the grass types are going to have a big resistance to us, so some of those are going to be able to get through to us. It does look like we inch out amongst a bunch of them, but it's really, really close. I mean, you can see this 505 up against Venusaur is pretty gnarly. I mean, one HP left for us is insanely close. I would just count that as a tie at that point, because according to like lag and server issues and all kinds of crazy stuff, we're probably going to end up tying rather than actually winning that. But anyways, our next Pokemon that we're going to look at is Raichu with a 54.5% win ratio, roughly, depending on which fast move you go with. It could, you know, kind of vary a little bit there. Definitely going to be targeting the Flyers, not really going to have any other big typing that we're going after here. But we do have the uniqueness of having Brick Break on Raichu here, which is actually really good. Now, of course, I do want to stress Cantonian Raichu, of course, not Alolan Raichu, but that Brick Break definitely does help us go up against the normal types, and it actually can help us go up against the Rock Boys, which we just talked about. Anything that does carry that rock typing can actually be hurt pretty bad when it comes to Brick Break, and even some more obscure Pokemon, like even Cradilly, should have a bigger problem with Brick Break compared to some other Pokemon. So, and that does give Raichu a little bit more of a footing in this meta than possibly some other Pokemon. So now we're actually going to check out Raichu here, and as you can see, we're just going to throw a auto-select move set on here. Not going to choose Thunder Punch though. Thunder Shock, Wild Charge, and Brick Break. Once we hit battle, you can see around 54.5% here. If we look at what we're good up against, these are no surprises here. Of course, a lot of the flying types are going to show up here. Those are pretty expected. Even, you know, Chinchou actually showing up there, which is pretty interesting. But a lot of these are just going to be kind of like oddball Pokemon once we get towards the middle. If we do shoot down and see what we lose up against, things that are pretty much going to resist our electric type damage are pretty apparent here. So most of the Razor Leaf users showing up down here at the bottom. Ludicolo actually showing up here, which is interesting. So it just seems like basically everything that can start to resist our damage is going to give us a problem, while at least being able to deal decent neutral damage back is just going to start to hurt us. Raichu is a weird pick, man. Our next Pokemon that we're going to talk about is Lantern, and so you can see I'm already trying to grasp for straws here. So Lantern, the reason that I feel like Lantern is actually going to be a little bit better than some of the other picks in this cup. One, we do have quite a bit of bulkiness in Lantern. I mean, he's always been an extremely bulky Pokemon, and there's no difference here. We're still, you know, a huge bulk threat running around, but we're just not quite as good as we would have been in other cups that we've seen Lantern in. But he definitely is a vet for sure. And oddly enough, Water Gun actually does perform better in this cup than Charge Beam does. And you guys know I've always been a huge advocate for Charge Beam, but honestly, I think water gun is actually gonna do just a tad bit better here yet again. So the big thing that I do feel like Lantern has going for it this month is not only is it a decent electric option, it's definitely more of a flex pick. It does have some problems with the grass type. The biggest thing is that it's a very nice cost-saving effective Pokemon this month. If you've already had a Lantern powered up in the past, then hey, you've already got a Pokemon that you really don't even have to power up this month. While it's not going to perform like amazing, it'll at least be decent, which is okay, right? Next, we're going to be taking a look at our Lantern here with Water Gun, Hydro Pump, Thunderbolt. Just hit battle here. As you can see, it's around a 43.3% win ratio, so it is sliding off a little bit compared to what we've seen already. But as you can see in the top section here, we do have a little bit of a difference in our matches because we do have that water type fast move this time. It's gonna be a little bit different. So like Anorith, we do have a lot of the flyers showing up here at the top. We do have Fortress actually showing up there, which is a really good one. Then a lot of the flyers again start showing up here. And if we just scroll down to see what we lose up against, no surprise here, we are going to lose up against most of the grass types, considering we do have that crazy weakness there. Some more interesting ones like Munchlax, Alolan Raticate is showing up here. We do see the Linoon, which we talked about in a deep dive earlier. Then you just kind of see there's some more awkward Pokemon here. Basically, Lantern's kind of in this weird state where it's kind of good, but it's kind of not. I think if you go with Lantern, you're really just trying to use it as a budget option. Or you're kind of playing a team that kind of centers around it, maybe. Like, maybe if you built a team around it, it would be really nice, but on its own, it's just kind of awkward for me. Our last Pokemon that we're working with here is gonna be Raikou. And Raikou is literally just digging from the bottom of the barrel. Like, I mean, the only thing that I can really say is that Raikou actually has Shadow Ball, which would be good in some niche cases, but nah, I mean, it's just kind of an oddball pick. And I tried to look at other Pokemon. I wasn't super impressed. Like, I've seen some of you guys talk about, like, Pachirisu, and I was even looking at, like, Plusle and Minun and things like that. They're decent, but the problem is that I hate the fact that they don't have any coverage. It's literally all electric-type moves or nothing. And that really is what I don't feel like that is what we're looking for in a top pick Pokemon, like the Rock Boys, the Steel Boys, Raichu. They all have quite a bit of utility in them. Even Lantern has more utility than just electric type moves. So I went with Raikou because it does have Shadow Ball. It will actually have some interesting use cases, although it can be pretty bad for you if you get into that normal type matchup. Shadow Ball is going to kind of be a weird option up against the normal types, but I mean, you do at least have Wild Charge, and Wild Charge is actually going to do pretty good there, so we'll try to go for that. I don't know. I even looked at Luxray and Luxio. I just... And our last Pokemon here with Raikou, let's actually look at Thundershock, Wild Charge, and Shadow Ball. If we hit battle here, you can see 52.2, so still a little bit rocky there. It's kind of awkward, but if we actually go to the top here, we can actually see, I think this is kind of where Raikou is starting to shine a little bit for me, because he actually beats quite a few of the Pokemon in this list alone. Magnezone actually showing up here. We should see there's Magneton. We have a lot of the flyers here, of course, just like we expect. Raichu actually showing up there. Electivire for what that's worth. Electabuzz for what that's worth. You can kind of see that it is beating a lot of the electric types in itself, but it's just kind of still awkward. So if we actually go down to what we lose up against, of course, those grass types with that crazy Razor Leaf damage are going to be able to output tons and tons of damage for us. Gonna really, really rock our world there. We're not gonna be able to output enough. We are kind of frail. We don't have too much bulk, so we end up losing pretty fast to any kind of like hard-hitting move like Razor Leaf. But I mean, Raikou is just kind of in that like weird state. I think you could probably use him. He's just, I don't know. It's just, he's one of those awkward ones. I don't know that people would really invest in Wild Charge and Shadow Ball. That's a big investment. But I mean, he's kind of like an anti-electric meta. Like, he's the anti-meta of the electrics, meaning he beats the electric type meta Pokemon, I guess. But I mean, I don't know, it's still awkward. So that is actually gonna be it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for hanging out. Thanks so much for watching. Always remember that if you do have a deep dive idea, you can drop those in the comments below. I do check every video that I get. Somebody will say like, hey, do a deep dive. So I just, whatever, any video that you want, you can vote for a Pokemon. Thank you so much for hanging out for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Always remember that if you like to like videos, you can do that. But if you don't, you can be that guy. Otherwise, let me know what you have to say down in the comments below. And until our next video, I will catch you then.